Glossary of Empowerment from the Gene Keys book. I keep opening to this one and I keep going, I'm not going to do that. And then here it is. So here we're launching in. These terms in the Glossary of Empowerment are, they take you into very deep areas, some of them. The monadic body. You know, that I have to give a small introduction. Well, let's just read it. The seventh major subtle layer of your aura corresponding to the monadic plane. So it's interesting to begin with this one because it's the widest, it's the most merged field explanation of what we really are. You know, these seven subtle bodies, these layers of dimensions of our being. And at the highest plane, you know, we are this, with the seventh one, you know, and you can relate these to the chakras. You know, the monadic plane is the plane of unity, of utter unity, the divine plane in which everything is one. The monadic body cannot said to be a body. Rather, it represents the point of origin of the current of involution or divine will. When human consciousness has attained its highest potential in the sixth atmic body, then it is said that the rainbow body dawns. This refers to the monadic body, which has often been symbolized as a flowering or a rainbow, since it is an expression of unity and completion. For the monadic to be expressed through human awareness, the lower three bodies, physical, astral, and mental, must be absorbed into their high frequency counterparts, the causal, buddhic, and atmic. When this happens, all layers and levels dissolve. All powers and cities are transcended and surrendered, and you become once again a truly ordinary human being. So we're starting at the end. I like starting at the end. Because the end of the journey is, you know, this is the sort of, when the curtain comes down and you suddenly realize you've been in this divine theater. And so you move through these layers and these levels and these trinities. You know, this is a really important thing to capture in the understanding of these seven subtle bodies, the rainbow body, is that there are these two triple, you know, layers. You know, the lower trinity is the physical, the astral, and the mental. And the higher trinity, as we said, is the causal. And then the buddhic and the atmic. Sorry, I had to get that for a moment. And so they cross-relate. So the lower trinity has to come together, and the involution force with the evolution force that's rising. Involution comes down, evolution rises up. I'll be doing more of these terms in the glossary. But the point is, you get this crossing over, you know, this. And as the lower bodies become absorbed in the higher bodies, and that's the purpose of our spiritual evolution, is to remember fully what we are and to incarnate the higher down here in the dense planes, on the earth planes, on the emotional plane. So for the emotional plane to be purified, for the mind to be cleansed and to reach clarity, and the physical body to be embodied fully. So the monadic plane is the seventh. It's the mystical seventh that kind of surrounds the six, the two trinities, and it then absorbs them into itself. They come from it and they, you know, they begin there and they end there. You know, our journey begins and ends in the same place, eternal place. It's a metaphor. It has to be a metaphor. All these subtle bodies are metaphors. And that's why the seventh body says, at the end, everything is transcended. Even the bodies themselves are transcended. Even the cities are transcended. Even these divine states, it all drops away. And you just become what you are. You just become ordinary, extraordinary, but ordinary. Just this, whatever you are. Returning from the mountain back to the marketplace. You know, the 10th bull of the Zen teachings. Everything has to come back to simplicity at the end and return to its source. And that's what the monadic body is all about.